Very good morning to one and all. And today we are discussing about unit number 4, non-conventional energy sources and the storage devices. Non-conventional energy sources అంటే మనం ఏం చెప్పొచ్చంటే non-conventional energy sources, what we are saying is natural energy sources. జనరల్ గా మన ఎనర్జీని ఎక్కడి నుంచి ఎక్స్ట్రాక్ట్ చేద్దామో చూద్దాం. ఇన్ జనరల్ వేర్ వీఆర్ ఎక్స్ట్రాక్టింగ్ ద ఎనర్జీ. ఎనర్జీ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ థర్మల్ ఎనర్జీ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ కన్వర్టింగ్ ఇంటూ మెకానికల్ and the mechanical energy in terms converting into electrical. I will tell you. In India, about 80 to 85%, I'm repeating, in India, about 80 to 85%, we are producing electrical power with the help of coal oriented thermal power plant. I'm repeating, the amount of thermal energy is liberated, the amount of thermal energy is converted into electrical energy with the help of TPP. I will tell you what is known to be a TPP. The word TPP is known to be the thermal power plant. Then what is known to be a thermal power plant? 80 to 85% of electricity is produced with the help of thermal power plant. Then thermal power plant which contained in the coal sample, repeating, thermal power plant which is contained in the coal sample, and the coal sample which burns in the presence of oxygen condition. What is happening in thermal power plant? Thermal power plant lo em jarugutundo okka jaatka chuddam. Thermal power plant which contained in the coal sample which burns in the presence of oxygen, coal sample containing the carbon, the reaction what we are saying is a combustion reaction. By the combustion reaction, it liberating carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide C+O2 gives rise to CO2. Along with that carbon dioxide, it liberating thermal energy. The amount of thermal energy is converting into mechanical energy. The amount of the mechanical energy in terms converting into electrical energy. I'm repeating. Now, electrical energy is produced from the coal sample, and the coal sample or the coal powder, which is burns in the presence of oxygen. Carbon burns in the presence of oxygen. C+O2 gives rise to carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide plus thermal energy. Thermal energy means that the reaction what we are saying is exothermic reaction, energy liberated by the system. The amount of thermal energy liberated during the combustion reaction, which is transfers to the water. Now the water energy is converted to the turbine. Rotation of turbines gives rise to mechanical energy, and the mechanical energy in terms converting into the electrical energy. This process is jarugutundi India loni. About 80 to 85% electricity produced in thermal power plants. We are using TPP, thermal power plants. Then what is the main drawback of thermal power plant? Now, when we are discussing about thermal power plant containing a drawback, which containing carbon dioxide is known to be exhaust gas. Generally, we know fossil fuels, then natural fuels, when extract. Now, when we are extracting the energy from conventional energy sources, just like carbon, just like petrol and the diesel, natural gas, when we extract energy, energy produced, there will be possibility of exhaust gases. So, the carbon composite liberating carbon dioxide is known to be that environmental pollutant. I'm repeating. Carbon dioxide is known to be that environmental pollutant. So, thermal power plant, when I used to say, the first drawback is, now we are using the coal sample, right? Which is non-renewable. Generally, when tons of coal samples are used, it is non-renewable energy. That means that when we have mines availability, we can produce thermal energy. The first drawback, consumption value. The first drawback is the demand. The second drawback is known to be that environmental pollution. Now, when we are depending too much on thermal power plant, will depend on electricity we produce, the problem is that then the liberation of carbon dioxide is environmental pollution. Carbon monoxide environmental pollution. During the thermal power plant liberating sulfur dioxide, thermal power plant liberating sulfur oxides, nitrogen oxides, carbon oxides. Carbon in the form of carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, nitrogen in the form of nitrogen oxides, sulfur in the form of sulfur oxides. They are known to be the toxic, right? Environmental pollution is identified because of the combustion of carbon composites. Carbon composites are burns in thermal power plants. It liberating thermal to the mechanical to the electrical energy. The main drawback is known to be that environmental pollution. Number two is known to be that non-renewable energy sources. So now we should identify the alternative method. You can have the question, right? The first question is the how we are generating the electrical energy, the how we are generating energy. Energy might be in the form of a mechanical or energy in the form of electrical. I'm repeating. The question is the how we are generating the mechanical energy or the electrical energy. The how we are generating the mechanical energy and how we are generating the electrical energy without causing any environmental pollution. Normally chapter. Okay. Now, let me ask you one question, right? What is known to be the mechanical energy? Best example. Now we are taking bikes and etc., right? The bike containing the two types of fuels, right? Now we are taking automobiles. Just I would like to mention automobile. When we are taking an automobile and these automobiles containing the automobiles which containing the fuels of two main classification. The first fuel I'm saying, the first category of the fuel is known to be the petrol and number two is known to be the diesel. Then a concept konchi manaku chaala important plus awareness in the concept and jaatundi. The first category I'm saying is automobiles, they would like to use petrol. I'm repeating. In automobiles, we would like to use petrol. In automobiles, we would like to use a diesel. I'm repeating. Then what is known to be a petrol and the diesel? The petrol and the diesel, they are known to be the petroleum products. Petrol is known to be a petroleum product and the diesel is also known to be the petroleum product. I'm repeating. When we are discussing about petrol is known to be the petroleum product and the diesel is known to be petroleum product, in both cases, now when we are taking in the automobile, when we are taking in the engine system, petrol engine system and the diesel engine system, petrol is a carbon composite and the diesel is also known to be carbon composite. I will tell you what is known to be petrol. Generally, when you have petrol and anything in the tank, petrol is known to be the isooctane and diesel is known to be that N-hexadecane. I'm repeating. Petrol is known to be that isooctane and the diesel is known to be that N-hexadecane. Then, when the petrol burns in that automobile combustion chamber, the process will be the same. Petrol containing the highest percentage of carbon, the diesel containing the highest percentage of carbon, the what we are saying is electrical ignition, the what we are saying is electrical ignition, and the carbon burns in the presence of oxygen in the petrol engine system, and the carbon burns in the presence of oxygen in the diesel engine system, then diesel engine what we are saying is a delayed ignition, and the petrol engine what we are saying is ignition, the same process, carbon plus oxygen gives rise to less amount of oxygen gives rise to carbon monoxide, C plus half O2 gives rise to carbon monoxide, and the carbon monoxide is known to be that environmental pollutant. Along with the carbon monoxide, liberating thermal energy. Along with the carbon monoxide, liberating thermal energy. Konchi concept jathke unna. So when we are discussing about automobile, in the automobile, the amount of thermal energy transfers into mechanical. I'm repeating. Then the equation identified in the automobile, that is nothing but the amount of thermal energy liberated. The amount of thermal energy liberated by the combustion of a petrol or by the combustion of a diesel, the amount of thermal energy liberated by the combustion of petrol containing carbon and the diesel containing carbon, petrol burns in the presence of oxygen and the diesel is burns in the presence of oxygen, the process what we are saying is electrical ignition. The process is known to be the electrical ignition. Then by the electrical ignition, it liberating thermal energy. The amount of thermal energy transfers into the mechanical. The amount of thermal energy transfers to the mechanical. The amount of thermal energy transfers to the mechanical is nothing but a moving of a bike. Okay. So we are using fossil fuels, right? We are using petroleum products. And these petroleum products, the exhaust gas is known to be carbon dioxide. Then when you're taking a petrol engine system by exhaust gas is known to be carbon monoxide. And the diesel exhaust gas is known to be carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide, when you're discussing an automobile in the system which containing the carbon and the carbon which burns in the presence of oxygen, C plus half O2 gives rise to CO. Thermal power plants liberating carbon dioxide and the automobiles liberating carbon monoxide, C plus half O2 gives rise to CO plus thermal energy. Exothermic reaction, amount of thermal energy transfers into the mechanical. So then what is the drawback of this system, right? Now, when we are using the conventional energy sources, conventional energy sources are nothing but we are taking a coal sample. We are generating the coal sample. The coal is converting into thermal energy. Thermal energy converting into electrical energy, where we are using in the thermal power plant. Then there is a possibility of environmental pollution like carbon dioxide, like this. When we're discussing about conventional energy, in the conventional energy where we are taking the petrol engine system and the diesel engine system, petrol diesel in a system which liberating thermal energy. Thermal energy transfers into the mechanical, where the exhaust gas is known to be carbon monoxide, and the carbon monoxide is known to be that environmental pollutant. Carbon dioxide is also known to be that environmental pollutant. Now let me ask you one question, right? In both cases, what we are doing, we are generating thermal energy. In the entire universe, there should be a requirement of thermal energy. That's why we are doing. అయితే మనం కోల్ థర్మల్ పవర్ ప్లాంట్స్లో కానీ మనం పెట్రోల్ డీజిల్ కానీ యూస్ చేస్తున్నాం కదా, ఎందుకు యూస్ చేస్తున్నారంటే మనకు థర్మల్ ఎనర్జీ కావాలి. థర్మల్ ఎనర్జీ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్స్ ఇంటూ ద మెకానికల్, థర్మల్ ఎనర్జీ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్స్ టు ద ఎలక్ట్రికల్, రైట్, ఫర్ ద మెకానికల్ వర్క్ డన్ అండ్ యాజ్ వెల్ ఎస్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ వర్క్ డన్. సో వెన్ వీఆర్ డిపెండింగ్ అపాన్ ద పెట్రోలియం ప్రొడక్ట్స్, వెన్ వీఆర్ డిపెండింగ్ అపాన్ ద నేచురల్ ఫ్యూల్స్ లైక్ ఫోసైల్ ఫ్యూల్స్, వెన్ వీఆర్ డిపెండింగ్ అపాన్ ద కోల్ శాంపిల్, రైట్, లైక్ లిగ్నైట్, natural gas and etc., when we are depending upon these type of the solid, liquid and the gaseous fuels, the first main drawback, which is liberating carbon oxides, sulfur oxides, nitrogen oxide, carbon oxide like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide is environmental pollutant, sulfur oxides are known to be that environmental pollutant, and the nitrogen oxides is also known to be that environmental pollutant. So the first main drawback when we are using fossil fuels in the environment which containing environmental pollution character. Let me ask for the second drawback. Second drawback is that the demand of petroleum production, day by day the consumption value increases. When day by day the consumption value increases, the demand value is also increases. Eppudaithe mana consumption value increase avutundo, demand value kuda avutundo increase avutundi. Consumption value ante em cheppochu manam, ante ee roju manam 100 tons upayoginchar anukondi, oka 1 month tarvata we are using 150 tons or 120 tons. So when the population increases, when the demand increases, when the population increases, when the demand increases, the usage of the fossil fuels, the usage of the coal sample, the coke sample, the usage of the petrol and the diesel, the usage of the heavy oils, the usage of the kerosene, the usage of natural gas, the usage of the LPG, the usage of the solid, liquid, gaseous fuels is also increases. So what will happen? There is an imbalance between, Jatkaran, there is an imbalance between the demand and the production. I'm repeating. There is an imbalance between the demand and the production, so the price cost will be rises. Generally, manaki availability takkuva dorukutundandi, eppudaithe availability manaki takkuva dorukutundo, okati cost aithe raise avutundi, rendodi consumption value kuda tagutundana, manaki consumption demand tagutundi, manam ekkuva mana demand chesina kuda manaki product value tagutundandi. The main drawback what we are saying is known to be that environmental pollution, right? More is the usage of, by using excess of usage of the fossil fuels, it liberating the excess of carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is known to be environmental pollutant. Carbon dioxide is known to be that environmental pollutant. So now when we are depending upon that natural fuels, when we are depending upon the petroleum products, when we are depending upon that fossil fuels, or when we are depending upon that conventional energy sources, when we are depending upon non renewable energy sources, jatkarinal, when we are depending upon that నాన్ రెన్యూబుల్ ఎనర్జీ సోర్సెస్, మనం ఎప్పుడైతే నాన్ రెన్యూబుల్ ఎనర్జీ సోర్సెస్ మీద ఎక్కువగా డిపెండ్ అవుతామో, ఫస్ట్ మెయిన్ డ్రాబ్యాక్ ఏంటంటే ఎన్వైరన్మెంటల్ పొల్యూషన్ అండి. ద సెకండ్ మెయిన్ డ్రాబ్యాక్ డిమాండ్. మనకి ఎంతైతే డిమాండ్ కావాలో ఆ డిమాండ్ బేసిస్ మనకు ప్రొడక్షన్ వాల్యూ అనేది మనకు రాదు. దెన్ వాట్ విల్ బి ద రెమెడీ, రైట్? టుడే ఐఎమ్ కమింగ్ టు మై టాపిక్, రైట్? ద రెమెడీ వాట్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్కస్ టుడే ఇస్ నోన్ టు బి దట్ కన్వెన్షనల్ ఎనర్జీ సోర్సెస్. ఐ విల్ టెల్ యూ వాట్ ఇస్ నోన్ టు బి దట్ నాన్ కన్వెన్షనల్ ఎనర్జీ సోర్సెస్. Now, when we are discussing about non-conventional energy sources, the first classification we are discussing solar thermal power plant. Ippudu nenu meeku cheppanu, coal-oriented thermal power plant. Now, what is the difference between a solar thermal power plant compared with that coal-oriented thermal power plant? It is known to be that STPP, MPP, solar thermal power plant. In the solar thermal power plant, we are taking parabolic troughs. We are taking solar power tower. In the parabolic trough and the solar power tower, we are taking solar panels and a jatka in the process. Now we are taking here parabolic troughs. What is known to be the parabolic troughs? As natural solar thermal power plant, we are in the solar thermal power plant, they are taking solar panels. You see this. What is known to be a solar panel? A solar panel is made up of a p-type and as well as n-type semiconducting material. You see this. Just మీరు ఎక్కడైనా అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తూ ఉంటారు, సోలార్ ప్యానల్స్ ఇలా ఉంటారా, ఈ సోలార్, దీస్ సోలార్ ప్యానల్స్ ఆర్ మేడప్ ఆఫ్, వెన్ వీఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ ద సోలార్ ప్యానల్స్, ద సోలార్ ప్యానల్స్ ఇస్ అ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ పి టైప్ అండ్ యాజ్ వెల్ ఎస్ ఎన్ టైప్ సెమీ కండక్టింగ్ మెటీరియల్. ఓకే, నా వెన్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ ఎన్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ సోలార్ ప్యానల్స్, ద నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ సోలార్ ప్యానల్స్ ఆర్ ఫోకస్డ్ విత్ పారాబోలిక్ ట్రఫ్. ఓకే, And these four solar panels are focused with the photochemical light, sunlight, with the help of reflector. I will tell you what is known to be reflector. Reflector is known to be mirror and మనం ఏం చేద్దాం అంటే ఇది సోలార్ ప్యానల్ కదా ఈ సోలార్ ప్యానల్స్కి నేను సర్క్యులర్ పాత్వేలో జాగ్రత్త నేను సోలార్ మిర్రర్స్కి నేను ఏం చేస్తానంటే సర్క్యులర్ పాత్వేలోని మిర్రర్స్ అరేంజ్ చేస్తాను ఓకే ఐఎమ్ కీపింగ్ ఎ మిర్రర్ హియర్ మిర్రర్ వన్ హియర్ మిర్రర్ టూ హియర్ అండ్ మిర్రర్ త్రీ హియర్ మిర్రర్ ఫోర్ హియర్ దెన్ వాట్ యు హ్యావ్ దెన్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ పాసిబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ మోర్ రిఫ్లెక్షన్ రైట్ వన్ ద సన్లైట్ ఈస్ ఫోకస్డ్ ఆన్ ద మిర్రర్ డైరెక్ట్ టువర్డ్స్ సోలార్ ప్యానల్ వన్ ద సన్లైట్ ఈస్ ఫోకస్డ్ ఆన్ ద మిర్రర్ డైరెక్ట్లీ టువర్డ్స్ దట్ solar panel then what will happen when the sunlight is focused on the mirror reflected towards solar panel the reflection containing the high concentrated solar energy when compared with the direct irradiation mana direct ga solar panels ki sunlight lo focus cheyadam kante meer chudandi parabolic troughs ani cheptadu parabolic troughs are known to be the mirrors nanu jaatu kutichukonanu the parabolic troughs are known to be the mirrors focusing the sun radiation which is focused in the photochemical light which is focused in the sunlight to the solar panel so we are getting the higher temperature right about 750 degrees centigrade we can reach the high amount of solar radiation I'm repeating the high amount of solar radiation that should be focused with the help of parabolic troughs I'm repeating with the help of parabolic troughs you see this with the help of parabolic troughs now we are focusing the high amount of solar radiation on the solar panels first point. Number two what will happen in the next the second condition I will discuss what is known to be the solar dishes that current I will tell you what is known to be the solar dishes here you are discussing which can store solar energy I'm repeating so when the solar radiation focused on the solar panel and here I'm taking a solar panel right the solar panel is made up of a p-type and as well as n-type semiconducting material solar panel is made up of a p-type and as well as n-type semiconducting material when the photochemical light is focused on the solar panel then what will happen it is a combination of a p-type and as well as n-type when a photochemical light is focused on the solar panel the amount of the photolight energy which is converted into the form of thermal energy simple the amount of sunlight the amount of solar radiation now itself converting into thermal radiation solar energy in the convert into the thermal energy then thermal energy in terms converting into mechanical energy in terms converting into the electrical so then what is known to be solar dishes indicating that the solar dishes which containing a fluid water system the fluid water system which stores thermal energy the amount of the solar radiation is nothing but a photochemical radiation focused on the solar panel the amount of thermal energy is absorbed by the solar panel and the solar panel what we are saying is a collector the collector transfers energy to the water system I'm repeating collector transfers energy to the water system and the water what we are saying as a storage of thermal energy okay that means that amount of the solar radiation which is converted in the form of thermal energy through the water system so water is going to be medium so when we are discussing about solar dishes the solar dishes containing a fluid water system and the fluid water system when we are discussing the fluid water system containing the fluid water when absorbing solar radiation that when the fluid water system when absorbing the solar radiation then what will happen when it is absorbing the solar radiation the water temperature increases when the water temperature increases the liquid state of the water is converting into the vapor state I'm repeating the vaporized water what we are saying as a steam vaporized water is known to be the steam ikka nunchi common andi simple meer solar radiation ni collector dwara water pampinchunnanu water anedi energy ni teeskuntundi eppudaithe water energy absorb ayyundo water temperature increase avutundandi water temperature increase aithe water is converted into the vapor state the vaporized water what we are saying as the vaporized water is known to be steam formation I'm repeating the vaporized water is known to be the steam formation now the steam is acting pressure on the turbine which is acting the pressure on turbine what is known to be turbine here jatkarda the word the turbines are nothing but you see this just let me tell you what is known to be turbine and here we can have a turbine like this and these turbines when we are discussing about the turbines can be rotated by the steam now the steam rotating the turbine simple that means that amount of the solar radiation in the form of thermal energy which is converting into mechanical I'm repeating amount of the solar radiation, which is in the form of thermal energy through the water system. Thermal energy is converted into the steam. The steam acting pressure on turbine, that means that thermal energy is converting into mechanical, and finally the mechanical energy is converting into the electrical. The process what we are saying is solar thermal power plant. Simple. Now let me see the last content regarding of the solar thermal power plant. Let's see this. Now when we are discussing about solar thermal power plant, right? The solar thermal power plant, you see this solar thermal power plant use sun radiation, solar radiation, and the solar radiation converts into the useful work done, which is converting into useful work done. Now when we are using the solar thermal power plant, which containing a liquid fuel or which containing a liquid water, which absorbing the solar radiation, then it is converting into thermal energy. The water is converting into thermal energy. Then thermal energy transfers to the water, and it is converting into the steam. Water is converting into steam. The steam acting pressure on turbine, you see this, the steam acting pressure on turbine, that means that amount of thermal energy is converting into mechanical energy. Further, it is converted into electrical generator. Electrical generator is nothing but further it is converted into that electrical energy with the help of electrical generators. Electrical energy can convert chestar. Let me see the sequence once, right? We are taking the collector. Collector is known to be solar panels. Collectors are focused with the photochemical light. Photochemical light is known to be solar radiation. Now it is attached to the water collector. Now water absorbing the solar radiation. Now the solar radiation in the form of thermal energy. When thermal energy is added to the water, water is converting into the vapor state. The vaporized water is known to be a steam, and the steam acting pressure on turbine, turbines will be rotated. That means that the steam energy is converting into mechanical, and it is connected to the generator, and the mechanical energy in turn converting into the electrical. In the entire process, what we are saying is nothing but, I'm repeating. In the entire process, when we are discussing the first one, what we are saying is a collector. Number two is known to be the converter, solar radiation in the form of thermal energy. And the next one is known to be the production of mechanical and as well as electrical energy, right? Distributed to the turbine system, and it is converting into the mechanical energy and as well as electrical energy. Then what is the main advantages of solar thermal power plants? Now itself, India is working on solar thermal power plants. India is working off non-conventional energy sources. In the non-conventional energy sources, the first main ideal thermal energy where we are extracting from the solar radiation. The first main advantage is solar energy is conventional. Every day we are getting solar radiation. మన సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ మనం ఈరోజు అబ్జర్వ్ చేసుకుందాం అంటే మళ్ళీ రేపటి లేదు అనుకునేవి. సోలార్ ఎనర్జీ నథింగ్ బట్ రెన్యూబుల్ ఎనర్జీ సోర్సెస్, రైట్? ఎవ్రీడే మనం సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ తీసుకోవచ్చు. ద ఫస్ట్ మెయిన్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఇస్ నోన్ టు బి దట్ రెన్యూబుల్. ద సెకండ్ మెయిన్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ వెన్ వీఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ ద సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ అండ్ రిపీటింగ్ ద సెకండ్ మెయిన్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ వెన్ వీఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ ద సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ నౌ వెన్ వీఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ ద సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ ద సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ విచ్ కంటైన్ ఈకో ఫ్రెండ్లీ క్యారెక్టర్. దట్స్ ఎనల్. వాట్ ఇస్ నోన్ టు బి ఈకో ఫ్రెండ్లీ క్యారెక్టర్? The word eco-friendly character indicating that there is no environmental pollution. Ippude manu cheptunnam meer automobiles lo petrol use cheyandi, liberating carbon monoxide. Diesel engine lo diesel vaadunnana carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is environmental pollutant. Right? Thermal power plant, manam coal sample ni tons lo coal sample teeskondi. Okay, now we are taking the highest amount of the coal sample, the tons of the coal sample which is burns in thermal power plant. It liberating carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxides, then and all these exhaust gases, they are known to be environmental pollutant. Thermal power plant lo chekkuga liberate ayyadi entandi, the highest percentage of environmental pollutant that is liberating in the thermal power plant is known to be carbon dioxide. Thermal power plants with liberating carbon dioxide is known to be environmental pollutant. So we are using a coal in thermal power plant, it causes environmental pollution, and there is a possibility of demand and the production. మనకు ఆ ప్రాబ్లం కూడా వస్తుంది. ద ఫస్ట్ డిసడ్వాంటేజ్. వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ ఫొజైల్ ఫ్యూయల్స్ మనం ఎలా చెప్తామంటే, జనరల్గా పెట్రోలియం ప్రొడక్ట్స్ అని చెప్తారు. పెట్రోలియం ప్రొడక్ట్స్లో మనకి త్రీ క్లాసిఫికేషన్స్ అండి, లైట్ ఆయిల్, మిడిల్ ఆయిల్, హెవీ ఆయిల్. జాగ్రత్తగా చెప్తాం. light and middle heavy oil. Now, when we are using the light and the middle and the heavy oil, light oil and the petrol, middle oil and the diesel, heavy oil and engine oil. Now, when we are using the light, middle, heavy oil in the energy production mana petrol lagani, like petrol engine system, diesel engine system, automobiles, space vehicles mana use chesthe, the main drawback is nothing but they are liberating carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is known to be the environmental pollutant, the second drawback. Okay, the first drawback is the production. The second drawback, production demand. The second drawback when we are discussing, is known to be that is environmental pollutant. So non-renewable energy sources are replaced with the renewable energy sources. Non-renewable man em cheddamandi, renewable energy sources to replace cheyandi. Then what is the main best example for renewable energy sources? Now when we are discussing about the renewable, the best source we are taking solar radiation, right? Solar energy is converting into thermal. Thermal energy is converting into mechanical. Mechanical energy is converting into electrical. Simple. Then what we are saying, it is known to be that solar thermal power plant. Then mani chestna ee process ni vadi emantadante solar thermal power plant antadu. Solar thermal power plant lo mani em chestnamandi, solar radiation ni collectors dwara meer collect cheyandi. Photovoltaic cells ani cheptadu, solar panels antadu nanu. సోలార్ ప్యానల్స్ బేస్ చేసుకుని మనం ఏం చేస్తామంటే సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ కలెక్ట్ చేస్తాం. సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ మనం కలెక్ట్ చేసిన తర్వాత అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ద సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్స్ టు ద వాటర్ సిస్టమ్ అండ్ వాటర్ ఈస్ కన్వర్టింగ్ ఇన్ టు ద వేపర్ స్టేట్. వేపరైజ్డ్ వాటర్ ఈస్ నోన్ టు బి స్టీమ్. స్టీమ్ యాక్టింగ్ ప్రెజర్ ఆన్ టర్బైన్. టర్బైన్స్ విల్ బి రొటేటెడ్. అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫోటో ఎనర్జీ, అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ద సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ థర్మల్ ఎనర్జీ విచ్ ఈస్ కన్వర్టింగ్ ఇన్ టు ద మెకానికల్, మెకానికల్ ఎనర్జీ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ కన్వర్టింగ్ ఇన్ టు ఎలక్ట్రికల్. The process what we are saying as a solar thermal power plant. So we are discussing about STPP, the first classification and the fourth unit, non-conventional energy sources and solar thermal power plant. We will see the following classification, the following points identified in the solar thermal power plant. Number one is known to be the parabolic troughs. And chepadu malli cheptanu meeku parabolic troughs anevi entante ippude mana discuss chesam solar panels ki manaku circular pathway lo meeku em chestarante మిర్రర్స్, ఆప్టికల్ మిర్రర్స్ అరేంజ్ చేస్తాడు. ఈ ఆప్టికల్ మిర్రర్స్ ని కంటిన్యూస్గా రొటేట్ చేస్తాడు. రొటేట్ చేస్తే మనకి ఏమొస్తుందంటే సోలార్ రేడియేషన్ అనేది మ్యాక్సిమం సోలార్ ప్యానల్ మీద ఫోకస్ అవుతుంది. ఫోకస్ అయ్యేటప్పుడు అబౌట్ 750 డిగ్రీస్ ఫారెన్ హీట్ టెంపరేచర్ వరకు మనం అట్ ఏ టైము సోలార్ ఎనర్జీని మనం ప్రొడ్యూస్ చేయొచ్చు, సోలార్ ఎనర్జీని ఫోకస్ చేయొచ్చు. నా ద సోలార్ ఎనర్జీ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ద హై కాన్సన్ట్రేటెడ్ సోలార్ ఎనర్జీని మళ్ళీ చెప్తున్నాను. The high concentrated solar energy is focused on the solar panel. Okay, now the solar energy in terms converting into that thermal to mechanical, mechanical to electrical. The first classification what we are saying is parabolic trough. Tarvata manem cheppamandi solar dishes ante em ledandi, solar dishes are nothing but solar dishes stores solar energy in the form of thermal. సోలార్ డిషెస్ ఏం చేస్తాయంటే సోలార్ ఎనర్జీని థర్మల్ ఎనర్జీ ఫామ్ లో స్టోర్ చేస్తాయండి. ఓకే, దట్ మీన్స్ దట్ టు స్టోర్ సోలార్ ఎనర్జీ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ థర్మల్ ఎనర్జీ, నౌ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ ఫోజైల్ ఫ్యూయల్స్ ఆర్ వాటర్. సో ఒకసారి ఫోజైల్ ఫ్యూయల్స్ వాడతాడు, ఒకసారి మ్యాక్సిమం కండిషన్ లో వాటర్ వాడతాడు. సోలార్ ఎనర్జీని డైరెక్ట్ గా మనం వాటర్ కన్వర్ట్ చేస్తే వాటర్ టెంపరేచర్ ఇంక్రీజ్ చేస్తాం, మనం స్టీమ్ జనరేట్ చేస్తాం. ఈ ప్రాసెస్ లోని స్టీమ్ జనరేట్ చేయడానికి మనం సోలార్ ఎనర్జీ వాడతాం కాబట్టి ఇట్ ఈస్ నోన్ టు బి స్టోరేజ్ మీడియం. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ నోన్ టు బి సోలార్ డిష్. Then what is known to be solar thermal power plant? Solar thermal power plant is nothing but a working condition. It is nothing but a working condition where we are converting solar radiation to the mechanical, solar radiation to the electrical. Solar radiation ni mechanical electrical energy ki ela convert chestunnaru, aa working condition explain cheyadaniki manu upayoginchadani em antadante solar thermal power plant antadu. It is all about today's first content. The continuation we will discuss concentration, non-concentration cells and photovoltaic cell expectation and that thing we will discuss in the coming class.